Hey guys, Lars here. This week I had a chance to play the second Battlefield 5 closed alpha, and even though it only ran for a couple of days, I was able to play and stream for several hours and capture some footage that you will be seeing in the background. So for this video, I wanted to give my thoughts and impressions about the game from the point of view of someone who plays Battlefield 1 pretty consistently every week and enjoys the competitive aspect of the game. In general, without going into detail about weapon mechanics yet, gameplay felt very promising to me, and that's the way I would put it. To draw some comparisons to Battlefield 1, it is more fast-paced at times, but also more tactical. It relies heavily on team and squad play, and the lack of both random bullet deviation and suppression are arguably the best changes in my opinion. Of course, new games are hardly ever shiny and perfect from the get-go, so Battlefield 5 also has a good number of opportunities, and not every new change is necessarily a welcome one, I think. To elaborate on some of this, let's start with the positives that I found and things I learned from playing the alpha. First, the game looks visually impressive. I play in 1440p with most settings in low and or medium, and the game for sure looks better than BF1. There is no doubt that the Frostbite engine is one of the most, if not the most advanced gaming engine out there right now. Second, the gameplay. And of course, this is the one thing people have been talking about the most. And so here's the way I'll put it. And again, from the point of view of someone who enjoys playing maybe a little more competitive and appreciates having solid team dynamics, because at the end of the day, that's what makes it fun, right? And so in BF1, you can get away with playing carelessly and just going for kills. You can run around more, and if you get shot, you can get away from that gunfight very quickly. That type of thing. That happens a lot of times. A lot of people play multiplayer FPS games like this too, and while it may seem like it works, in reality, it'll get you killed a lot too. In Battlefield 5, you will die even more with a playstyle like this. That means being more tactical is more important than ever, and the same applies to going for things like more intelligent positioning, picking your targets, picking corners more carefully, and avoiding running into open spaces without taking a quick look around first. These are all tactical strategies that in Battlefield 1 you can totally ignore, and you may still come out in a good spot, but it's a very different flow in Battlefield 5, and I think that's great. Now, you can still run as a lone wolf and do well, don't get me wrong, but I believe you'll have to employ some of those strategies I mentioned more consistently to actually enjoy doing that. This also ties directly to the emphasis on team play in this game. For example, when you're down, you cannot cancel on revives and go directly to the spawn screen, which is always an irritating thing players do in Battlefield 1 anyway. Also, because of this new concept of attrition, you need to be more mindful of your health and ammo and rely on your teammates or supply stations around the map to get them back. One of the changes that DICE implemented in this second close alpha was to give players one more ammo magazine whenever you spawn, and this is a really good thing in my opinion, because before you would just run out of ammo after spawning just far too quickly. So I hope this is a change that they keep in the game. Another thing that I liked, and I think this is a huge change, is the predictable recoil patterns for weapons. So the way it works is that each weapon's recoil pattern is unique now, so which, as DICE put it, this gives the player an opportunity to master each individual weapon. Now, this is one of those changes that I actually felt more than others coming from Battlefield 1, and it's nice and threw me off at first too, that each time I picked a different weapon, I had to remember that there is no bullet deviation, and instead what I should be thinking about is the recoil pattern for that particular weapon. Now, this is something that will take time to get used to once you get your hands on the game and start using the guns, and it's another change that I think will help separate more skilled and experienced players from others. Of course, playing a second alpha, I personally didn't have any time to be thinking about, hey, let's remember the pattern for this weapon, especially since those are things that DICE might tweak, but I know it's something that I will be actively thinking a lot once we actually start playing the game when it launches. Now, finally, the grenade spam in Battlefield 1 seems to be gone entirely, and being an infantry-only player, I also love the fact that I wasn't dying to airplanes and vehicles just all the time. But this is an extra, this is an area that I'm sure we'll see quite a lot of changes before launch and in future updates too. Now moving on, in my opinion, some of the more important criticism and opportunities that I think DICE has with the game at this stage are number one in my list, improving the scout class. Keep in mind that for both alphas, there was only the Kar 98 rifle to play with, and one change that DICE made on the second alpha was to decrease the max damage range from 20 to 8 meters. They also decreased the minimum damage from 60 to 55. They lowered the bullet velocity from 700 to 600 meters per second, and a couple other changes that basically nerfed the scout significantly. This translates to sometimes maybe having to take 3 shots to kill an enemy in the mid 100 meters range, and also having to aim very high above their heads to land those headshots, sometimes by a lot. Now, in Battlefield 1, I play mostly mid-range, close-range sniper, and especially feeling that massive bullet drop here in Battlefield 5 made the experience a little less enjoyable, really. So I hope that this is something that DICE considers changing, especially with all the similar feedback that they're getting about the scout class now from the community. Personally, I think the sniper changes in Battlefield 1 were pretty good, with the exception of Sweet Spots and the Super Shiny Skull Clint, both of which are gone in Battlefield 5 anyway. So the scout class in Battlefield 5 in general felt like a big nerf to me to begin with anyway, especially with the changes I just mentioned from the second alpha. Now, one thing that DICE changed that I do agree with, however, is the player's headbox being a little larger than in Battlefield 1, and this helps with getting those headshots. Right now it's more in line with what it is in Battlefield 4, if I'm not mistaken, and I hope that this is something that DICE leaves the way it is right now. Another change that goes hand in hand with the scout class, and that I don't think necessarily is a bad one, is the spotting flare. In BF5, these are what DICE calls high altitude spotting flares. The higher up you fire them, the larger the spotting radius will be on the minimap. Also, the effect lasts quite a bit less than in BF1, meaning that you will see your enemies spotted for less time, and you spawn with one flare initially and get 2 in total after resupplying. Now for gameplay issues, key points for me were that first of all, I could barely hear other enemies' footsteps, and it was also challenging to know where I was being shot from. This, together with the excess of particle effects like the snow in the map, and of course the bad netcode every now and then, this being an alpha, caused me to die very quickly sometimes without a chance to even react to the enemy or just to go for cover. Another item on this list of improvements to make is that it was a little hard to notice when a grenade landed next to me. The red highlight just wasn't prominent enough, and I've seen other players comment on this as well. And so even though the timer for the nades is 1 or 2 seconds longer than in Battlefield 1, I assume to allow for grabbing and tossing them back, I feel it doesn't compensate for the slight lack of visibility. So maybe when DICE reduces the amount of particle effects visible, this won't be so much of an issue, but we'll have to wait and see. Now finally, we still have some lighting issues when going in and out of buildings, just similar to Battlefield 1. So it can be tough to see objects and players sometimes, but hopefully this is something that in the upcoming beta we won't see anymore, fingers crossed. So there you have it guys, those are my thoughts. Most of this and other feedback I posted it in the Battlefield 5 forums that DICE open for the alpha players, and if you want to read that or add to it, you can find a link to the description below. Overall, I think Battlefield 5 is on a great track, and I am super, super looking forward to all the updates that DICE will be running from here until the launch in October. And just for the lack of suppression and random bullet deviation, I'm down to play the game. Now, and by the way, don't forget that this open beta that I just talked about will be in September, where you can try out the game for yourself. So I'm sure there is a lot of stuff that I missed or didn't get to experience during the alpha. So what are some things that you came across with maybe, or saw in other YouTube channels that you liked or disliked? What do you think about Battlefield 5 so far anyway? Leave a comment and let me know. If you enjoy this content, please give it a thumbs up. and maybe check out some of my Battlefield 1 videos and subscribe for more. I'm starting to stream more regularly on Twitch, and I will also be posting more BF1 and BF5 highlights, raw gameplay, and even doing some giveaways too. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.
Das wird dir helfen. Hier, erste Hilfe. Erste Hilfe, hier.